Just as a refresher, parallel lines, remember, have the same slope and they never will cross each other. For example, here we have a couple parallel lines. These are very short lines, but we know they keep going and going and going. And just picture these never crossing each other. Here's another example of parallel lines. They could be pointing any direction, but they always have, again, the same slope and will never touch. A new symbol we're going to use to represent parallel lines is kind of like our congruent symbols, but instead of congruent symbols, they're arrows. So if you have two arrows, one on each line, that means they are parallel. Or say, for example, here we could put two of these arrows. That would mean that these two lines are parallel. A new term that you might not have heard before is called a transversal. A transversal is just a line that is crossing between two different lines. For example, we have that transversing those parallel lines. Over here, we have this line transversing these two parallel lines. Now, when we look at parallel lines and transversals put together, we find some very interesting things. So let's go ahead and get into those. Notice I've gone ahead and drawn a beautiful pair of parallel lines in addition to this lovely transversal that is transversing those lines. Now, if you look a little closer, we'll notice that these parallel lines and this transversal form many angles. We've got an angle here, 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 and here. These angles are going to have various relationships that are going to be very useful to us. Okay. I'm going to get into those. Let me get some of my tea really quickly. I love green tea in the morning. Up, we've got an oldie but a goodie. Vertical angles. And remember, vertical angles are just the angles directly across from one another. And we always know that vertical angles are congruent. They always have the same measure. So in this case, our vertical angles are 1 and 4. We've got a vertical angle, angles of 2 and 3. We've got vertical angles of 5 and 8. And we've also got vertical angles 6 and 7, always directly across from one another. Next up, we've got another familiar friend, linear pairs. And linear pairs are always supplementary. Remember, on linear pairs, we're always looking at two angles that, when added together, are 180 degrees and they're always on a line. So for example, if we had this, if we were focusing in on this line, we'd have the linear pair of 1 and 2 as well as 3 and 4. If we were focusing on this line down here, we'd have the angles 5 and 6. And then we have another linear pair of 7 and 8. Now, let's shift our focus over to these lines right here. This will give us linear pairs of 1 and 3, 2 and 4, and if we focus on this line right down here, we'll get linear pairs of 5 and 7, and 6 and 8. And since these are supplementary, they'll always add to 180. Getting into some new stuff, we have corresponding angles. Corresponding angles are always congruent. They have the same measure. So in corresponding angles, you can kind of focus in on this transversal, this middle line. They're always on the same side of the line and they skip over to the next parallel line. So in this case, we have corresponding angles of 1 and 5. We also have corresponding angles of 3 and 7. So you can kind of see how they skip over one of the other angles all the way over and one angle on each of the parallel lines. If we look over at the right side, we've got corresponding angles of 2 and 6 as well as 4 and 8. Again, the corresponding kind of jump over one angle all the way over to the other side and the other parallel line. Next up, alternate interior angles. And alternate interior angles are always congruent. They have the same measure. Whenever you see the word alternate, you want to think of opposite sides of the transversal. So this side is alternate from this side. Whenever you see interior, you're thinking the inside. So we're thinking the inside of the two parallel lines. So our alternate interior angles here will be 3 and 6. They're on opposite sides on the interior. And our other pair of alternate interior angles will be 5 and 4. Again, they're on opposite sides as well as on the interior. Next, alternate exterior. These angles are also congruent. Now you might be able to kind of guess what these are. We know alternate is the opposite sides, and exterior is going to be the exterior of the parallel lines, the outside. So for our alternate exterior, we've got 1 and 8, as well as 2 and 7. These angles are congruent. Our last type, consecutive interior. These ones are supplementary, which means they add to 180. You might even be able to guess what these ones are. Consecutive, instead of alternate, consecutive means on the same side. Interior still means on the inside of the parallel lines. So our consecutive interior are 3 and 5. They're consecutive on the same side of this transversal. And then our other pair of consecutive interior angles are 4 and 6. And these all are supplementary, so they add up to 180 degrees. Really quickly, before we sign off, I just wanted to show you some interesting things you may encounter from time to time on your journey of mathematics. Here we've got 3 parallel lines with a transversal. Now try not to get thrown off, because you'll notice if you just take your hand and you cover this bottom parallel line, you've got 2 parallel lines and a transversal, just like we had before. If you move your hand up here and cover the top parallel line, you've got the same thing on the bottom. You've got your 2 parallel lines with the transversal. So if you can focus in on those, it's the same angle relationships that we've talked about. Even if you have something like this, you could still take your hand, go ahead and cover up this bottom part, and you've got 2 parallel lines right here with the transversal. You can move your hand up here to cover the top portion. Again, you've got 2 parallel lines with the transversal. What if we did this here? Whoop! Let's cover up this right side. Again, 2 parallel lines with the transversal. Same thing, we could cover the left side. We've got 2 parallel lines and a transversal. So just because it looks a little interesting doesn't mean you can't focus in and still talk about some of the angle relationships that you've learned.